Hey, hello, this is Mick O'Boyle from old Sydney, Australia. I wanted to ask you about what the class of 83 was like. What were they like?
I don't know, but I'm in school.
83 will go on forever.
Hi.
You're awesome.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi.
It's Steglik.
Teddy, you're a scrub.
Oh, really?
Loser.
Yeah.
Toys and children laughing and everyone's so nice and my boss gave me a raise today. Ooh. But there's so many things to do and ornaments and everything like that. Oh, excuse me, sir. Do you see that Christmas tree over there? One of the big star on the top. It is so beautiful. It lights up the whole room.
You know, that reminds me of the Star of Bethlehem.
Of what?
Star of Bethlehem. Haven't you ever heard of the Star of Bethlehem?
No.
Jesus in a manger?
No. But I know of Santa Claus. He comes down the chimney with a lot of toys and presents for all the children
no,
and everything.
No, the real Christmas story.
No.
It went this way. Just as I was reading in Isaiah, therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. And you see, Jesus is the light of the world.
What about Greg Caltran? Didn't he have a nasal congestion problem or something? Beltran.
Start now. Just go.
What about Greg Beltran? Didn't he have a nasal congestion problem?
Yeah.
Yes.
Hi, Mom.
Hi there.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, my name is Keith. I'm from Redondo Beach, and God, it's hot. I sure could use a
Coke.
That's my
boy. Coke. That's mistaken.
Patty, Chapman, you were on. Patty, you guys look this way.
Okay, here we are with the two noted biblical scholars of the from Fremont Christian School, and they are noted for their knowledge and biblical skills and Old Testament and New Testament survey. And we like to ask them a panel discussion question. Mr. Brown and Mr. Anderson, what color is God?
Black.
Thank
he
you.
Is brown. He's brown.
Red don't white.
Like this. Oh.
He's white.
He's white. Okay. I'm here interviewing Craig Rendon, the world's greatest eater. Craig gives the best head in the world.
Check out this belly. Check out.
Look at this belly, folks. Look at this belly. Look at that Craig Rendon belly.
Yeah.
That is Craig Rendon. That is apple pie, and that's Chevrolet.
At this time, I would like to introduce to you the class valedictorian for 1983, Miss Jennifer Rhodes.
Hi. If you hear some clicking, it's my knees knocking together. Okay.
Our senior class has come a long way from insecure freshmen in September of 79 to victorious seniors this year. We have learned and grown a lot in the last 4 years. We found out what it was like to go out with style. The Lord showed us the thrill of victory, and no matter how much it hurt, we also felt the agony of defeat, or at least we found out what it was feel to be unwanted. Thank you, Mr. Aquarius and Ms. Northcutt, for taking us when nobody else would. Our class has grown together and hopefully learned from our past mistakes and trials. We have also definitely gained some pride from our victories. As James 1, 2 through 4 states, count it all joy, my brethren, when you meet various trials, for you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness, and let steadfastness have its full effect, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking in nothing. God has brought us this far, and now he will lead us on as individuals from here. Our school and our class have had many victories this year. Our school and our class, oops. God has been very generous, and the students have worked very hard in order to achieve them. As it says in Luke 1:37, for with God nothing is impossible, even this speech. The guys' soccer, basketball, and baseball teams all did very well, placing first in all of their leagues, or tying some of them. The girls' teams all worked very hard and did quite well also. The choir, under the direction of Mr. Guzman, has grown and matured over the years. We received excellent reviews this year in our performances, and it was probably the best part of my whole senior year. The drama department also did very well. They did two very excellent plays, The Belle of Amherst and Anne Frank. Students have grown individually also. Various students have received scholarships from colleges for either scholastic or athletic ability. Various awards have been given tonight to quite a few well-deserving students this evening. God has raised the class up both as a group and as individuals. This class has come a long way, but now we have to look forward to the future, toward a new and slightly scary future of college, travel, or employment. We will no longer have good old Fremont Christian to lean on. However, we will not be alone, as God has brought us this far, and he will lead us the rest of the way. He will be with us in our new, mature, and responsible world. As the Bible says in Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through him who strengthens me. As we look forward to our future, we also look back to our past and remember our friends. We have made some wonderful friends. I have Breck and Helen, who have made these last 4 years marvelous. All three of us are going in different places after graduation, and we won't all be together always, but we will always have our friendship and our memories. This class as a whole will probably never be all together again as we are now or as we have been, but we will always have our memories of our good times. We'll be able to make new memories with new friends as we go our separate ways. As the poet Johnson wrote, if a man does not make new acquaintances as he advances through life, he will soon find himself alone, as a man should keep his friendships in constant repair. This is not the end of anything except high school. An unknown author wrote, you never really leave a place you love. Part of it you take with you, leaving part of you behind. We'll still have our memories of Fremont Christian, and we'll still have our friendships. God did not bring us this far to leave us. We made it through the first 3 years of high school with God's help, and he made our senior year the best it could be. God is always faithful to us, and he will always be there if we call on him, for he has good things planned for us in the future. Jeremiah 29:11 says, for I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare not for calamity, to give you a future and a hope. We are now going to embark on our new independent lives. With God as our guide, how can we go wrong? This is our commencement exercise, which means to start or to begin. We are starting the rest of our lives. This is not an end, but a beginning to a lifetime walk with God. I hope that each person in this class will find happiness in the future. I hope they always remember to do their best in whatever they do, and to do it with God as their help. Thank you.
What about music? Didn't you guys have some kick-ass rock and roll?
Faith to faith. name, not a number.
Senior class, all I gotta say is our senior class owns this stick here, right? And tomorrow night against homecoming, we own that stick. Hey, Brandy, cool it. This is serious. Tomorrow night at that homecoming, that hoop over there,
20-point victory, man.
It's gonna be at CSD and it's against Valley. And I will rip the nets, just like if you were here the other night, and if you've seen the game, well, you know, okay? There ain't nobody that's going to hold me under 20, and if they do, they're going to have to triple team me. I just want to thank all the guys on my team, my coach, Mr. Doherty, and assistant coach, Mr. Herb Mitchell. And we've been averaging 95 points a game, and most of all, I want to thank God because he gave me the talent to play basketball.
Assembled on the Boston Common in preparation for an expedition, Paul Revere rode through the countryside, alerting the colonies with the cry,
Swarm! The other side!
Historical walk.
The 1982-83 homecoming queen is Glory Wright.
Switzerland, and her brand has a Porsche, a real life Porsche.
This is why I own a 911. To me, there is no front end like a 911. It is a work of art, okay? Now, on my 911, I've had a few things done to it. I've had Bosch fog lights with protective casings on the fog light system. And here is my other brass plate that I mentioned before, the $35 at Pier 39. They're really nice. Okay. This right here is my gas cap, and this works from inside the car. Watch the cap. That's a protective type system, so nobody breaks into it. I think it makes the car a lot nicer. You have to shut it from this kind of an angle. Okay, now I'm going to show you the fog lights.
So now, ladies and gentlemen, the senior class would like to invite you to celebrate our country in singing of the national anthem.
Back up, man. Stick to me.
Tony, are you talking?
Yeah, I'm going to be interviewing.
You're going to do an interview on me.
We're here at Fremont Christian.
Cameraman.
We're here at Fremont Christian Camp.
I can't wait till I graduate.
We're here at Fremont. Would you shut up?
Okay.
We're here at Fremont Christian Campus, and we're here talking to Teddy Steglik, the owner of this fabulous camera. If you would like to witness, please call his number. What's your number?
797-1990 and area code 415.
Teddy, tell them the amphibious thing you can do with your beard. Do it, Ted. See that? That's a mutant. We have Tim Evers here, the Fremont Christian Jack Jerkoff Championship of the World. And we have Alfred Anderson with his big booty. And we have Greg Kennedy with no kind of V. He just got Tim. He needs a bra.
What about music? Didn't you guys have some kick-ass rock and roll?
The name of our song is Lust, Oi, and Ow. Words, lyrics, and all music by Ronnie Carr, Sam Anderson, and Craig Rendon.
Who mentioned my name?
Go.
Go.
You gotta hurt me so bad. Baby, baby, don't hurt me like that. Baby, I love you. I love you so much. Baby, I lust over your little bust. Baby, every you hurt me so bad. Baby, 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 baby. Baby, come on down. Come on down to the side of the town. Let me really get down. Come on down to the side of the town. To the side of the town. Where we really get down. Come on.
My friend, Sam on the drums.
Ow, 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 ow. Where we rock, 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 and we roll, roll, roll. Come on, come on down, come on down. Make me feel good.
Hi, my name is Lori Ramos, and this is my Porsche 944.
Okay, on a Porsche 944, it's a little bit similar to a 924, but there are a few differences, and I'm going to tell you, and Lori here is going to point them out. Now, these flare out the fenders here. Right here, and see how it's creased up here on a 924. It's kind of rounded down, and that's one major difference in this car. This car also, the 924 is all Audi and Volkswagen engine. This car is total Porsche engine, just like the 911 and 928 model.
Okay, this is the back of the 944. This is called the turbo tail, and this is a standard feature on the 944. That is different from the 924. That is extra. Right here are the bumper pads, and they're just serve as protectors for the car. Right here are my brass plates that my mother and father bought for me at Pier 39. Right here are your brake lights and, you know, and the 944 emblem right there. I don't know if the 924 has that. Right here on the turbo tail, I like this because it says Porsche, if you can focus in on that.
It's Eric de Koning. I'm from Belgium, and I heard Greg Kennedy is doing commercials for Charmin T-shirt.
Of our nation developed a document never before conceived in the human mind. Let's take a look at one of these leaders ever diligently working, James Madison.
Now let's see. We, the senior class, in order to form a perfect. This is the 83rd time. Perfect. P-E-R-F-E.
Cindy, that name sounds so familiar. Wasn't she that real cutie pie?
He's so sexy. I just love it when he talks.
It has been said that there are some men that are men of few words, but as my Bible class can attest to, I'm not one of them. We will try to keep it fairly short. I just have a couple of things that I'd like to say. First off, this is what I call the class that came from nowhere, because that's just about where we found them when we picked them up. They were $1,200 financially in the hole at the end of their junior year. They were filled with a number of cliques throughout their little organization, or lack of it. They were classified as the rebel class of the school, and maybe justifiably so. They criticized the school for everything we did wrong and for a few things we didn't do wrong. They were, in our vernacular, as adults, they were considered the bad class. But something happened over the summer. A new president came in, a new group of people came in, and we had our first meeting, and they decided they were going to work together and convince everybody that they were all right, that they were great. They had some success. They went to their first rally and won the first spirit stick. It's the first thing they'd ever won as a class, their whole whole history of the class. They proceeded to win Dickens Day, and not only win it award-wise, but they also managed to actually make it profitable for a change. They won many of the class competitions, and they wrapped it up, from what I understand, the first class ever to take a clean sweep when they took the Spirit Week Award at the end of the year. I recall one of the other class counselors approaching me that morning and saying, "Mike, I can't believe it. You just don't give us a chance." You know? And in Tony Brown's vernacular, Tony would have said, "We is bad."
Fire!
When I climb out of my Porsche 911, looking like a stud, and knowing I can own every woman on the street, when they come up to me, you know what I say? You can't afford to ride in this car, honey. That's the break.
Tell me more, oh Brandy, tell me more.
You know, it's a shame owning a Porsche 911, and it's a shame to dress as nice as I do, because you know why? Every girl in town is after one thing. They're after this, buddy.
So what'd you think?
Well, I don't know.
I
liked it. I really did. I liked it, but I'm not sure if I want it. I'm really not sure.
Oh, come on.
Well, what do you think you're going to get for me?
Well,
tell me that much.
I don't know. I've seen this gorgeous gold necklace that had a big, huge diamond in it. Oh, I know they'll get it for me. They'll get me anything I want.
Wait a minute. It's not like your parents had to go on welfare.
Oh, yeah, your parents.
You are not rich enough to get that much.
My parents will get anything I want.
A mink coat, a diamond necklace, a Gucci bag. Give me a break. You're not rich enough to get that stuff.
You want a dang Texas Instrument computer, and you can even have.
Hey, my parents are so much richer than
yours. Oh, your parents are so much richer than your dad.
My dad.
Good. We're here at Fremont Christian High School, and we want to interview Greg about you in the.
The total of the school. See the way you hold that. How do you hold that bike like you really want
to? Is it on, Ted? Ted, is it on?
Yeah, it's on. White. Back it up here. You're not the.
Hey, we're here talking
Cody,
to Greg.
Cody, you got your head to the bike.
We're talking to. We're talking to Greg Beltran, King Jackoff champion, and he is in our he is in the Bing Crosby clam bake.
I can't remember when you were there. Can't imagine anything we've missed. Can't imagine the two of us can't do. Through the years, you've never let me down. You've turned my life around. The sweetest days I found with you. Through the years, I've never been afraid. Life we've made, and I'm so glad I stayed right here with you through the years. I can't remember what I used to do, who I trusted, who I listened to. I swear, you've taught me everything I know. Can't imagine needing someone. I need you more and more. Through the years, through all the good and bad, I know how much I've always been so glad to be with you. It's okay, I'll stay with you.